When I'm shopping for an acoustic guitar, I care about one thing and one thing only. How good it sounds, acoustically, unamplified. If I need to amplify it, I'll figure out a way to do that later. In pretty much every situation, a microphone is going to be the best sounding option. However, it's not always convenient for obvious reasons. If you're next to a drummer, or you're in front of stage wedges, or you want the ability to walk around and move around on stage, a microphone sounds the best. However, it's not often the most convenient solution. The second best option we have for amplified and acoustic guitar, unfortunately, is through some sort of pickup system. It's one of my biggest pet peeves that a lot of high-end acoustic guitars are coming with undersaddle piezos, and that's simply not a great way of amplifying a guitar for the simple physics of it. The undersaddle piezo is sensing the vibrations of the strings solely, just the strings, through this little plastic or bone saddle. It doesn't give any reference to the way the acoustic guitar is actually vibrating and resonating. Rather, it's just taking the signal from the strings. There's a much better system out there. It still operates on the piezo principle. However, with this method, we're actually sensing the vibrations of the actual body of the guitar instead of simply the strings. Today, I want to introduce the Journey Tech body transducing system. The point of this video is to provide a couple A-B comparisons between the Journey Tech and a more traditional undersaddle piezo pickup. So you can see I've installed it here in a more temporary manner because I want to be able to play the exact same playing samples. I want to record it at the same time and just flip between them so that you get the most scientific results possible. We're limiting all the variables here. Right now we're going to do the blind shootout. So we're going to listen to two different samples that were recorded at the same time, just simply through two different pickups. And I want you to decide for yourself, is there a difference in sound, number one, and number two, which one sounds better? And then lastly, which one do you think is the undersaddle versus the body transducing pickup? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. Now, there are plenty of reasons why I prefer the body transducing system over an undersaddle piezo, and that actually have nothing to do with the sound quality. For now, let's just listen to it and then we'll talk about those few points after we're done. Thank you. sure you picked up on a little bit of a difference there. Depending on what you're listening on, I'm sure it might come across as a really subtle difference, but to me, the body transducer system provides a lot more of the important information that you need to be able to identify a nice sounding acoustic guitar versus a rubber band. The first sample was the undersaddle piezo. The second one was the body transducer. Did you get it right? Was there a difference at all in your opinion? Let me know in the comments. And for now, let's talk a little bit about why I prefer a transducing system. Now, there's three reasons that I tend to prefer the pickup that I do. Lowest on the totem pole, reason number three, is that I just think they sound a little bit better. They sound more authentically like your guitar for like why I said earlier, it reads the resonance of the instrument instead of just the little saddle vibrating. The second reason is that it doesn't need a preamp. We're removing all the extra stuff from the inside of the guitar. It's not rocket science. The more weight you add to an acoustic instrument, the less it's going to be able to resonate, and the quieter it's going to sound, and yada, yada, yada. It's just going to sound better the less junk that's inside it. And lastly, the biggest reason that I don't want an undersaddle piezo in my guitar is that it's disconnecting two of the most important contact points in the instrument. You've got the strings, which is where the magic's happening. The body of the guitar is what's resonating and creating the full sound that you want. When you break that connection between the saddle and the bridge, you're really harming the guitar's ability to transfer vibrations from the strings to the body, and in turn, you're harming the resonance of the instrument. Now, a few months back, I had switched, like I said, from an undersaddle piezo to a body transducing system in my Martin D28. That was the K&K Pure Mini, which cost twice as much as the Journey Tech. One of these days, I'm gonna shoot them out back to back. So the Journey Tech is 50, the K&K Pure Mini is 100. Pretty much the exact same thing. Piezo pickups are pretty affordable to produce, so I don't think there's gonna be much of a quality difference, but be on the lookout for a video comparing the two there. And if you like this pickup, you can check it out at the link in the description. Journey Tech as a company saw that video that I did a few months back, and they offered to send me this one just so I could do a comparison. I already knew that I liked this pickup system much more than a piezo, but I wanted to provide a resource for the community. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe to the channel. I have a lot of acoustic videos talking about amplifying acoustic guitars and different strings to get the best acoustic tone possible. And I'm sure you're gonna find something else on the channel that you like. Again, thanks for checking out the video, and I'll see you in the next one.